I think he thought that I was Nick. I'm Righteous Nick. Masquerade, this is a GM player. They probably pre-made with Malkavian, he was also a GM player. Do we have any GMs in our team? In a fellow Chromie main. He didn't play Chromie this season though. I think Sereny is a GM. I kinda remember this name. No. Voxley. We don't have a single GM and we're playing versus two GMs. Okay. Oh, I'm banning. I actually don't really like Chromie on Curse Hollow. I'm just gonna highlight her for now, but I'm probably not gonna walk her. I'm gonna ban 8C here. I don't really care about Avatar that much. If they go Avatar, I can always force like Vikings. Pre-made murky OTP. Why do these master players keep going with 4-man pre-mades, 3-man pre-mades, man? Are you so scared to go alone and prove yourself worthy? F2E Colos, 3 pre-made. Happy capped, 1 pre-made. Potato Girl! See, that's the serious player. I know Potato Girl. She is a fellow streamer and an Anna main. She's playing how it should. Wait! 4 pre-made! What the fuck are you doing, man? Stop abusing the match. This is why they need to bring Hero League back, man. Because matches are totally unfair. And I know for a fact that Masquerade on the enemy team and Malkavian are also pre-made. Because I know they're double GM players. And there is no way the matchmaking is gonna decide to put two GM players in one team versus zero GM players. So that means that there are three teammates, might be like Diamond 1 or something. Sylvanas first pick, okay. Lucio. Phoenix Lucio. Don't dare to play solo, they much rather play pre-made, but why do they wanna play pre-made besides like getting free wins? Like, how do you enjoy getting a win when you're going pre-made? What satisfaction does that bring you? Oh, I just stomped a couple of World Master Diamond players and I just got 3 points. You don't get any value by honing your skills with an equal skilled players. You're just stomping on those people and think you're good because you're climbing the ranks. But realistically, you're not doing shit, you're just getting carried because you have a good group. I'm sure Masquerade is a current GM. Malkavian is definitely a next GM, I don't know if he's current at the moment. Nah, Valkyrie, they're not friends at all. I can understand if you wanna play with your friends around like Diamond, Platinum and Gold. But trust me, people in GM and Master are not really that big friends. They're like, oh. Am I buying it? A noob. No, actually, I really like Garrosh ban into Zero to Diablo. No, I'm not buying an Avatar, man. Some people just combine well with my party. Each has a set of raw, and that's it. But I preferred Hero and Team Link, to be honest. Yeah, exactly, Fifuromere. I think that if you prefer, like, if you like to play with someone, you prefer to build like a team of people that you enjoy to play, that you'll enjoy their skill, there should be a different matchmaking when you put people with a people that have some cooperation versus other people that have some cooperation. I don't think it's fair to put like randomly put people versus people that can trust themselves. Actually, I think I wanna force Vikings here. Fuck it, let's try it out. I haven't played Vikings for a long time. They might go for a hard counter into Vikings, like a Illidan or something. Fuck it, man, let's try it out. I think you should have a choice to choose between grouping or going solo, man. I don't have fun grouping with any other people. I like to go in solo, man. I only enjoy grouping with other people. Only enjoy playing the game with the... Ooh, Nova! That's a good counter. I need to play careful versus Nova. Only enjoy playing the game when they... they know they have a much higher chance to win. Yeah, that's not enjoyable. Let's see. Malto is rank 12. Malkavian is not GM. But I'm sure that Malkavian is an ex-GM player. He must be very close to GM. But again, you have a top 10 GM almost versus 0 GMs on the enemy team. Kinda seems a bit unbalanced, man. I think they do that because of the current matchmaking, putting them with diamonds instead of after queuing Masters Plus, and try to reduce the number of Pepega players with them. What? I don't know, I feel like the queue timer is still way too low to put actually good matches. I think they need to extend the queue timer at least 2 times. It shouldn't be like, it should be instead of 100 seconds to like 200 seconds on average. In my opinion. Okay. Oh, Viking bribery. I'm gonna be extra focused here. I want GM, but if it's a good MMR, you won't put like the top 10 GM. You're gonna put like, let's say, top 90 GM into the match. So it still seems a bit not fair, man. Like, I understand putting a borderline GM with other masters. But they're putting like one of the best GM players currently in Hero League, in Storm League. I need to be careful of Nova ganks here. Nova is on top. Hello? Nova is soaking the bottom for now. Nova is still top. Strange. Why is no one soaking the other Vikings lane? Viking lanes. What the fuck is happening? Strange. No one is soaking. What? Shouldn't Nova be ganking me? Yeah, there she is. Oh, I'm getting ganked by Malta. Okay, that's fine. That's fine. That's fine. They just stay back here with the small Viking. Yeah, but why do you want to remove ex-GM players? Like, ex-GM were people that proved themselves in Hero League. And the only thing I like about Storm League is the reset. The reset was cool, okay? Resetting the ex-GM players from the MMR, that was good. But I don't think you should force people to play together so they grind ranks, man. I don't enjoy grinding ranks with other people, man. I like to grind ranks on my own. And not having to be destroyed by pre-made groups, you know? I'm gonna go healing regeneration on Eric. Why did Eric recall? Did I die? No, I didn't die. Why did Eric recall there? What the fuck? You can switch the lanes, boys, now. Yeah, you can switch. Malta going for tower, though. You see Nova? Now we can have a good sustain. I'm gonna switch those two Vikings. Most of the times, the game I lose, because people on the enemy team get a better coordination after the mid game. That's why I lose most of the games. Well, master players kind of know how to play their heroes and kind of know how to rotate. But when it comes to a serious mid to late game team fight and knowing how deep you can go, how deep you can bait, how to kite, they're very, very not good on that compared to other people that you can trust. Like, when they see a pre-made ranged assassin with a healer, like let's say a Vava Uriel, it's obvious how well their coordination is because they can trust themselves. The difference is so much obvious compared to the random people, man. It's like day and night the difference. Gonna need to switch those Vikings again. Oh, Bobo. Okay. Actually? I kinda like the shield, man, just to be able to bait Nova. If she ganks me hard. Phoenix. And Nova going a bit low there, but I do have health sustained. Oh, you missed Nova. Maybe I can kill him? That's the real clone. What the fuck are you doing? In my opinion, Team League players are part of the player base. I'm fine with Team League players, man, as long as they have their own matchmaking. I don't want Team League players to get matched with solo league players, man. That's the problem. I like the old system. You can choose whatever matchmaking you want, not be forced with other premates as a solo player. That Nova was a master player that they killed there, by the way. Kappa. I actually have 3 stacks. Actually, the Viking games is going very well for us at the moment. Mainly because the 4-man, our 4-man is doing very well. Very strong 4-man. Gonna bait Nova with the shield. Nice. Let's not overextend because she can snipe me. I'm just gonna try to cap this. No, back away with this Viking. Hello, Nova. Oh, you missed a shot. And now Nova is baited. Oh, we lost top though. I'm on the objective. We got Nova. I'm gonna move Eric to top now. I think Eric is better if he's on the top because he has a lot more survivability and mobility. I think that's gonna be better. Oh, free experience. Nice. Big Viking. I kinda wanna invade their siege there real quick. I actually don't really often pick Vikings, but I thought this was a good opportunity. Vikings is a very risky pick, and you also kind of need to be able to trust your teammates to be able to execute properly. I see Phoenix going hard here. That's fine. Oh, I'm gonna kill my Viking. That's wall though. Damn. That's wall. Let's go middle. I stopped his recall at least. Let's be annoying. Alright, dude. I couldn't teleport everyone there. Nice farm, yeah, nice kills by the Phoenix there at least. Well played by him. I have 4 stacks, he got the siege. I'm just gonna respawn all the Vikings now. But my team is dominating hard at least, so that's cool. Lost some people there. Almost got the keep though, okay. Oh, this is an easy camp here. Okay, nice, we're getting a lot more kills. I actually like all of COE damage. Just because I like him. I mean, a lot of people go for jump to dodge stuff like ultimates, which is a very good good choice. The thing I like about this talent is Olaf can now be a good pusher as well, compared to the other Vikings. Because Olaf doesn't really push, and now with the COE damage he can actually push. Which, that's why I like this talent. Also, the flame can help you reveal Nova clone, which is some kind of a worthy thing as well. So yeah, those are the reasons here. Uh oh, yeah, I know that they're coming here. I'm gonna soak the bottom and actually try to do the siege with Beowulf here. Oh, Phoenix coming in. That's fine. Let's just keep pressuring bottom. I'm not letting you kill me, Phoenix. I have movement speed. Is that? Oh, easy, Usio. What the fuck? Let's join my team here. Run, 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 run. Off here. Let's auto-attack the Phoenix as well. Double kill with the Viking. actually had no idea Lucio was there, man. I had no idea. I need to kite the siege here. I don't wanna talk about this anymore. Yeah, I mean, we have different visions about the game, man. I can understand. Sock here, AFK here, keep doing the siege. I agree with you, Stormwing should be a party queue only. Also, queue should be removed from the game. What? Oh, my Viking is dying. That's fine. We still have the other two Vikings alive. That's completely fine. They forced a lot of people to go bottom for that Viking kill, which is fine. I'm gonna go Olaf stun. I like the stun as well on Olaf. I'm gonna try to cap this. My team is pushing, so... If they go hard... Oh, we're pushing boss. If they go hard on me, I can just summon all the Vikings here. Oh, they got the camp though. Let's see. I'm gonna start moving Eric as well, just in case they kill me here on the tribute. Cool, that's fine. I'm gonna pressure bottom as well a bit. Olaf moved there. Oh, I'm sorry. Misclicked. My team is... I think they're having a good time, hopefully. I cannot watch on them at the moment because I'm pushing the sides. I hope my team is fine. I'm sending Olaf there slowly but surely. They seem fine, we're pushing the bottom, they're getting some kills. Well played team, let's try to gank the Nova. Nova? Oh, I'm gonna gank the Nova here. Nova! Come here, Nova! Should be GG, man. Well played by everyone, man. I did my part and they did their part. Actually, it was... I don't think I did anything too much on Vikings, man. I was just talking. I actually wasn't really paying that much attention. I was, like, reading chat and stuff. And when I turned back my vision from chat, I see a low HP Nova. I turned back, low HP Lucio. It's a fun game, man. Hey! We didn't lose the game because of the GM premates, I think. Let's see, the Phoenix was a GM, right? No? Huh. Okay, so... Malteo didn't do that good job to hunt the Vikings. Nova did a terrible job. And Arthas just feed. Huh. It does make sense to put Malteo versus Uther. Because Malteo's sustained damage is very good into Uther. So it does make sense to put Malteo on the foreman. And put Phoenix and Nova to chase the Vikings. Because you put two ranged mobility assassins to chill the Vikings. That makes sense. But Nova played bad. Like, that was a very bad Nova player. Phoenix played very well. Pretty much, Nova was useless. That's why their team lost. Because instead of Nova grabbing a lot of experience for her team, she herself fed experience for my team and we're always a talent ahead. So I think... I'm not saying that their foreman did well. But Nova really was a big problem for them in my opinion.